Y de su acostumbrado servicio religioso pasaron a la cárcel. Esa es la historia de una pareja de pastores cristianos del área metropolitana de Atlanta y sus dos hijos, que tras finalizar el servicio del domingo, fueron recluidos en la prisión del condado de Gwinnett, en Georgia, acusados de haber agredido a unos oficiales de la policía. El arresto de la familia se produjo cuando las autoridades llegaron para tratar de rescatar a una menor que supuestamente ellos mantenían en contra de la voluntad de la madre y por ser de 16 años, tiene la potestad sobre ella. Aquí estoy, aquí estoy, aquí estoy. Cuénteme.
Yo soy la que le mandé mensajes de que tenían a mi hija, que no la dejaban tener comunicación conmigo. Okay. Esta gente, la señora de la iglesia gritaba. Ellos gritaban que Difaz les había dado la custodia. Eso es mentira. Yo nunca he regalado a mi hija. No he regalado a mi hija nunca.
Because you've got three misdemeanors. You have a willful obstruction of law enforcement. A theft by taking. An interference with custody. Those three are misdemeanors. You have a felony charge of obstruction on a police officer. And there's no bond on that.
Officers received a call to investigate a runaway juvenile, possible interference with custody. Prior to getting on the call, the officers were able to look in the call notes and find out and confirm that it was in fact a Gwinnett County Police Department report filed on a runaway juvenile and a interference with custody. Once they got on scene, they were met with by one lady who advised she was the one that called. She was the interpreting for the runaway juvenile's mother and said that they had just seen the juvenile get into a tan Escalade, which was still parked at the location, and they were fearful that the juvenile was going to leave in the vehicle. At that time, the officers approached the tan Escalade to investigate. And they did see a juvenile, two juveniles sitting inside the car. As they approached to try to investigate it, they were met by several subjects who immediately became very uncooperative and not answering the officers' questions when they were trying to ascertain who owned the vehicle and who was in it. The situation then escalated very quickly because the subjects continued to press up on the officers and get on. The officers kept giving loud commands for them to back up, back up. One of the officers, using his training on crowd control, took out his asp and held onto it to kind of push the crowd back. They began yanking, and then it escalated very physically at that point with them grabbing the officers. At one point, an officer's radio was taken from them, which at some point during the scuffle, the other officer tried to call for backup but couldn't call for backup because the person that had the radio was on the radio at the time talking on it. Officers then tried to deploy a taser. During the scuffle, that taser was taken from the officer and actually pointed at the officer, which unfortunately the officer used his best judgment, and that didn't end any worse than it could have. There was some OC sprayed again, trying to get the crowd back and get the subjects off of the officers. A physical altercation ensued for several minutes in two different locations where the officers were trying to subdue the subjects and keep the crowd back. Fortunately, the officers were eventually able to get all four subjects in custody and arrested and charged accordingly, and the juvenile was returned to her mother safely.